Let's talk about writing task 2. In this video, I will present a question from IELTS Academic 18 and walk you through the steps to write a good essay for it. Right, so as usual, we need to spend some time on the statement to understand it. So this question reads, "The most important aim of science should be to improve people's lives." So the topic is about the aim of science, and that should be to improve people's lives. Now let's read the instruction. To what extent do you agree or disagree with this statement? Well, for this one, you could simply say I agree or disagree, or I agree to some extent, to a large extent, or partially agree, and so on. But my recommendation is to take a clear side and simply say I totally agree or totally disagree. So we know that you need to write 250 words to be able to develop your answer, but if you write even 2040, 2045, that would be also possible to develop your answer. Like the essay I'm going to present today, it's actually 241. The reason I didn't write more than that is to show you that you don't have to write more, and writing more is not equal to a better score. All you need to do is to answer the question clearly, support your opinion, and develop your paragraph. That's all you need to do. Now, we understood the topic and also the instruction. Now it's time to decide if we agree or disagree and why. So for this one, I agree. Why? Because I think science is very powerful and can help people in different ways to improve their lives, right? So I decide to focus specifically on medical and environmental problems. Science has the potential or the power to solve those problems. So I focus on medical and environmental problems. So the first thing to write is to paraphrase the question. This is my paraphrase. Let's read it together. It is said that the primary objective of science should be to enhance people's lives. So I just added the first part, it is said that, a passive part, to introduce the statement. Instead of the most important aim, I use the primary objective of. And instead of improve, I used enhance. So the rest of them are quite the same. The second thing I need to add is to clearly mention my opinion. Like this, I totally agree with this. And this here refers to the statement before that. And now I need to say why I agree with this. So I need to support that briefly here in my introduction. Remember, we said that because science can help people solve medical and environmental problems, which leads to healthier societies, but I need to make it a little bit, let's say, more formal and use better words. So this is my final version for this. Because science can improve their lives by solving medical and environmental problems and promoting the overall well-being of communities. That's all. That's my actually introduction. Quite simple. I didn't add any extra things. I simply paraphrased. I wrote my opinion clearly, and I said why I think like that. In other words, I answered the question. So when the examiner reads your introduction, he knows what to expect in the rest of the essay. And it's also easy for you to write and organize your ideas because you've already answered the question. And all you need to do is to take the first part out, which is medical, this part, in your first body paragraph and develop that. And take the second part, which is environmental, and write it in the second body paragraph and develop that. So let's start with the medical part. So I need to repeat my reason in my first body paragraph as my topic sentence, but I need to paraphrase it, right? So here's my topic sentence. Science has immense potential to impact and change people's lives for the better in multiple ways, such as healthcare and medical advancements. Now I need to say why or how. This is the explanation. Through scientific research and innovation, groundbreaking discoveries have transformed disease diagnosis, treatment, and prevention. New technologies have revolutionized healthcare, improving the lives of millions of patients worldwide. Now, I need to conclude actually my sentence, to write a concluding sentence or remind the reader of what I said earlier. You don't have to write this sentence, but I like it. Therefore, science should follow the same path in the future to mitigate healthcare concerns. Now that I finished my first part, medical issues or challenges, I need to focus on the environmental side in my next paragraph. Furthermore, I want to add, right, so I use furthermore. Science can be crucial in addressing urgent environmental issues like global warming. Why or how? I need to explain and develop that. It also helps better understand these complex problems and develop sustainable solutions. For instance, in the face of climate change, scientific advancements have paved the way for renewable energy technologies such as solar, wind, and other clean energy sources to reduce the impact of climate change. Moreover, by investing in scientific research, it will be possible to create a greener and more sustainable future, ensuring the well-being of current and future generations. Now, I developed both parts, both issues and challenges, medical and environmental. Now, I need to conclude. I can say that your conclusion is somehow the paraphrase of your introduction. Why? Because you repeat the same idea. And you summarize the main points you mentioned earlier, right? Just paraphrase what you said in your intro and that would be a good conclusion. But do not add anything new to that. I mean, any new reasons. So we started with in conclusion as a transition word. So I repeat my idea. I strongly believe that. So this part is the statement again, but I paraphrase it. Science should elevate the quality of people's lives. Why? Again, I summarize the two reasons. The remarkable capacity of science to profoundly impact and improve their well-being is evident through progress in medical technologies and the provision of sustainable solutions for environmental challenges. I repeated the exact ideas, but I just paraphrased what I said earlier. I organized my answer in four paragraphs, my introduction, first body paragraph, second body paragraph, and my conclusion. So there are different things that give cohesion and coherence to my writing. The first thing is using transitional words or linking words like moreover, furthermore, in conclusion. The second thing is using pronouns, right? It gives grammatical cohesion to your writing, like it, these, their, instead of repeating the same nouns again and again. The third thing is writing clear topic sentences. At the beginning of each paragraph, I introduced my topic sentences and the main ideas clearly, and then I provided supporting evidence by explaining and providing examples. Also, the logical organization of my, let's say, paragraphs added to the cohesion and coherence. I had an introduction, then body paragraphs, and a conclusion, right? And the last thing is consistent tone and style. By tone, I mean, I mostly use formal phrases and collocations and language. That was consistent throughout the essay. I didn't use a combination of formal and informal language. My tone and my language and my style was consistent or the same throughout my essay. And these are some collocations and the definitions from this essay that could help you a lot with your essay writing. So you could pause the video and take screenshots to read and review these collocations later and use them in your own essays. They're very useful. All right, hope you found it useful. This is actually my first video on writing task 2. Let me know if you want to know more about this in the comment sections or the question types you would like to see more content on. Have a nice day.